Well, by now, surely we're on a roll. Let's see what would happen if we had a volume of charge. Let's take a little cube right here. I'm going to center it at the origin just for convenience of drawing it. And let's say that it has a volume charge distribution of 7, x, y, z. And that's obviously volume because our units are going to be coulomb per meter cubed. So here's our x direction, our y direction, and our z direction, and let's say that it goes to 1 in all of those directions and is centered at the origin. Same steps as before. I've drawn a convenient coordinate system and I'm going to choose an origin right there. I need to write rs. Well, rs in this case is going to be xs in the x direction plus ys in the y direction plus zs in the z direction. That's a vector from the origin to some place here on my source. Then I'm going to write a vector rp, which is to where I want to find the electric field. Let's say that I want to find the electric field. I want to be able to find the electric field any place on the xy plane. Well, the only thing that means is that z is 0, but that my x or my y could be anything. So I'm going to call that xp in the x direction plus yp in the y direction plus 0 in the z direction. Notice I'm using the s's and the p's to keep my sources separate from my field points. Now go back to the same process. I want to find a vector from my source to my field point, which is just rp minus rs. It is equal to xp minus xs in the x direction plus yp minus ys in the y direction plus zp minus zs in the z direction. The magnitude of this vector is xp minus xs squared, yp minus ys squared, zp minus zs squared. Take the square root. The unit vector, rsp, is just our original vector divided by its magnitude. And then we're going to do the same thing that we did before. We're going to write a little differential element of electric field, which is going to be rho v dv divided by 4 pi epsilon magnitude squared unit vector. In order to find the electric field, we will do a volume integral where our rho v is going to be 7 x, y, z. What kind of x's are these? Are these xs terms or are they xp terms? Because these are associated with a source, these are xs terms. And then what is our dv? If I took a little unit of volume right there, that would be dxs, dys, and dzs. Divide that by 4 pi epsilon magnitude squared, and then this unit vector, rsp. I would integrate from xs equals 0 to 1, from ys equals 0 to 1, and from zs equals 0 to 1. Now let's talk about what we are integrating. Notice that our integration terms are all associated with the source. None of these integrations are over the point. That's because we're adding up the pieces of source, we're not adding up the pieces of point. That means that this vector right here, xs, is one of the elements that's getting integrated. This vector, or this piece that's down in the bottom, is also getting integrated, but this is not. The xp, yp, and zp can effectively be treated as if they were constants. They're variables, but they are not variables of integration. So it's a very important distinction to keep track of what it is that you are integrating.